So we're here at the Gaylord, and it's convention season is coming up. It's going to be in full swing soon. Generally in the DC metro area, it kind of starts with KatsuCon in February, and then just kind of rolls in throughout the summer.
Yep.
So we decided, creatives chat,
that we're going to go explore where to shoot at the Gaylord in a big old crowd, which we don't have today.
Right, we don't have it today, but we're specifically keeping those places in mind where there is a lot of traffic. You know, sometimes people, like, all they can think about is that perfect gazebo shot.
Right.
And there are other places, I hate to tell you, photographers, other than the gazebo to shoot.
Here's the thing. I don't go to cons, and I haven't shot here often.
Right.
So I'm taking a very fresh eye at shooting here and picturing it full of people.
Right.
First thing I'm going to tell you that's good is that you've got a massive softbox on top and in front.
Behind us.
And what's bad is you got a massive softbox that's coming in one direction.
Right.
So you need to think about the fact that you want your model facing that softbox, or you need to make adjustments.
Right, and I'm coming at it from the perspective of, like, I have done cons here before, and there are always, like, those places where photographers are like, I really want to shoot at the gazebo, or I really want to shoot at this place, and I'm like, why do we have to shoot at the most crowded places? There are places that where you can get to that will make lovely shots that are not super crowded. So that's what we're going to show you today.
And so some of the places that we've been playing around with are things like, there's buildings in there.
Yep.
So you can put somebody with a little building and a little garden-y stuff behind them.
Yes.
And it's, and even if it's crowded, you can cut out the crowds. And yeah, they'll walk around you for a few minutes while you take some shots. And by the way, everything we did was no strobes.
Right, no, we didn't bring any, we just used natural light today, basically.
Right.
So.
I think one of the biggest issues that I found there is that you want to shoot in a certain direction and you're backlighting your subject.
Right, right. Like the gazebo shots. I mean, I hate to keep coming back to it, but there have been so many shots in my life that I have seen in that gazebo and they're backlit and they look horrible. They look horrible.
And the way to fix that for the gazebo is really very simple.
Sure.
Almost all DSLRs have exposure compensation. You set your exposure compensation up a stop or two, and it will overexpose according to the camera metering.
Right.
But your subject will be properly exposed. The gazebo will still look decent, and your back background will be blown out pure white. So here's Sierra in the gazebo, but she's backlit, and you can see that she's underexposed. So by me coming outside the gazebo, I still have this gazebo framing her, and I let the natural light hit her, we get a much more even and pretty exposure. But there's also other areas around that gazebo area that can give you some nice drama, some nice framing, and don't be afraid to use them. And of course, even if it's freezing cold, get outside and enjoy the natural light outside. Oh my God, that was fun.
So that was fun, yeah. So
a little bit more adventurous than we expected.
Did not expect fire drill, a fire.
Wee-oo, wee-oo, wee-oo.
Yeah, so we're here at the Gaylord
shooting.
And there's a fire emergency.
We didn't do anything, swear to God.
Yeah, so those are our tips and tricks for conventions. It doesn't have to just be for this convention hall. It could be for many convention halls. Finding those small spaces where there really aren't a lot of people, especially, you know, an interesting backdrop can be anywhere.
Also, look for the direction of light. Yes. And don't shoot in those areas where it's crappy, unnatural light. Look for the big windows. Definitely. Use your good light.
Yeah, you definitely don't have to always bring all this gear to cons in order to get good quality photos.
Nope, you just want to look for a good location, a nice tight location, an interesting location, and face your model towards the light.
Yes.
That's it. So thank you for watching.
And we'll see you next time on Creatives Chat.